Hey, Robbie Miller, Tangible Parish President here at Hammond Square, where you can come shop, dine, and play, and have your pictures taken with Santa by Becky Blunt on Palace Drive. Merry Christmas from Hammond Square.
House on the Rock in Ameet was the scene of the latest Sheriff Daniel Edwards monthly prayer breakfast, and he joins us now. I guess you've got maybe seven of these, right?
Let's see. I go through June, so that would probably be six, huh? If you start January, February, March, April, May, June. So I got six more, and then and talking to Sheriff Sticker, Sheriff Alex Sticker, I can tell you, I think he's gonna keep these going. He told me that he thinks that this is a really good idea, so I'm sure these will continue, but I will lead six more.
Well, you know, your colleague in Livingston Parish, Jason Arndt, said that he tried the round robin approach, going to different churches, and he gets more attendance at a central location. So I don't know which is better.
Well, you know, if I had a training center like he has, you know, in a setup, maybe we would keep one centralized too. I can see where both have their advantages, Ken, but one of the things that I find fascinating is, you know, our phone rings from different churches, from different places that want us to come to them. And I just think that's a really neat setup. It's worked well for us. We travel throughout the parish. As you know, we'll be in the center of the parish some, and then sometimes we go to the edge of the parish on the north, south, east, and west. And so I kind of like it that way, but if it's not broke for Sheriff Ord, he ought not fix it, and I don't think it's broke for us, and so we're not going to try to fix it here.
Knock on wood, and I know your guys hate it when I say things are quiet, because knock on wood, something else can happen. But on the other hand, you know, dealing with the perennial problem of juvenile crime and talking to your wife, Judge Blair Edwards, the juvenile judge here, it just seems like, yes, things are a little bit better than they were maybe a year ago, but on the other hand, what a challenge. And if we had the answer, why, we could go nationwide because it's everywhere.
Well, that's true. Right now I think things are going okay on our front, but certainly the juvenile business that we have, that we send to Judge Edwards Court, I mean, it's pretty brisk right now, and it has been for a while. And again, what we see is a lot of kids that are just not being supervised. A lot of kids have access to guns. They're fascinated with them. They want to carry them either on their person or anytime they're in a vehicle. And a lot of times, you know, Ken, that's just not going to end up well anytime there's a fight, argument, disagreement, or anything like that. And so, you know, that's probably the biggest concern I have, is the juvenile population and their infatuation and the ability to get guns in their possession.
So I know during the pandemic that a lot of this involved these gangs and just really intricate patterns of acquiring these guns. It seems like, though, you ought to be able to get them off the streets. But on the other hand, you are getting them off the streets.
We get them off streets every day. But just think about, and we've talked about this before, I think the number one place these guns are coming from is the ones that are being stolen out of people's vehicles who oftentimes don't lock their doors. So when we deal with car burglaries, Ken, and we have plenty of car burglars in our parish, just like we do all across the state and the nation, it would almost shock people to realize how often people leave valuables in their car unlocked, including guns. And so I think a lot of the guns are coming, you know, from places like that, and they own the streets, and it's not that juveniles are buying guns, you know, from a store. That's not happening. But when you have enough guns that are being stolen and on the black market, they can get their hands on them that way. And I think that's what's happening.
So oftentimes the fights we see in school have a component off campus. What advice do you give to the school board as they continue to tweak their discipline policy?
Well, you know, for first off, I try to stay within my lane, you know, and I don't want to try to get involved in that aspect of it. I don't envy the situation they're in, because, you know, one school of thought is you can only deal with children, you know, whose actions occur, you know, on campus. The other one says no, because what they do off campus spills back over to campus, so you have to police that too. And so then you have the school system basically trying to police the students 24/7. And I don't know that I have the right answer, but I think anytime the school system is aware of any information that some kind of a fight or feud or whatever you want to call it, a retribution can occur, whether it's off campus or on campus, they certainly need to let law enforcement know what they know, so that we can get involved early and be more proactive than reactive.
Well, I see I hate to be Pollyannish, but I see tremendous improvement now compared to right after the pandemic, when we were just starting to get back to normal. And I think as more after school programs and activities return, that's got to do some good.
Well, I think that's true. I think, you know, I've been taught my whole life, you know, an idle mind is the devil's workshop. If you give children or people in general something to do, something constructive to do, they're less likely to go astray and to get in trouble. I think there are a lot of services that can be provided, and as more of these things open up, I hope that you're right, and I believe we'll see some of this stuff come back to a little bit of normalcy.
Well, and look at your Young Marines program and the other things that you try to do at the Sheriff's Department.
Well, that's correct. You know, anybody from 8 to 18 in our Young Marines program can, you know, I tell you, I've gotten so many compliments over the years. And again, is it a perfect program? No. But when you try to teach kids about responsibility, about, you know, being patriotic, about, you know, trying to care for their neighbor, certainly, you know, their belief in God and whatnot, I think certainly good things will come from that. And that Young Marine program has been very successful.
Well, speaking of which, you know, the pendulum is turning, and the fact that we now have more prayer in school and at school board meetings. There are countries in this world that have a religion component to their penal systems, because at some point when you're dealing with criminals, you have to get back to right and wrong. And maybe it's a non-denominational thing, but it seems like a no-brainer. Yet you've been restricted at what you can do at the Tangipahoa Hope Parish Jail, correct?
Well, yes, and that is partly true. And let me just say this, Ken, you know, addiction is a terrible thing, right? But one of the most successful ways to overcome addiction, you know, has been through a 12-step program. And certainly, you know, basically, you know, belief in God or that there's a supreme being is a key component of that as well. So if you can do that and change people's behavior who are addicted to something, then I think, you know, having that same mentality and focus on a higher power, I think can certainly help curb, you know, criminal conduct. So I think that they're definitely all related, as you just pointed out.
What else are you working on at the Sheriff's Department? I guess this time of year, you're incredibly busy.
Well, so first off, you know, tax notice. Let me just tell everybody, your tax notices are out. All of them have been mailed out. I don't know if you've all received them yet. That's kind of up to the post office, but tax payments are going very brisk. I mean, people are just walking in, paying. People are paying by mail, and certainly that's always, you know, a good thing. If you, for whatever reason, did not receive your notice, hey, you can call us. You can call the assessor's office. We can certainly get that information to you. But you can also go on the website and look up your property values and your tax values there, and can even pay from there. So don't let it be an excuse that the mail didn't come to you, so you didn't pay your property taxes. That would be a very bad thing to do, because ultimately you're going to end up owing penalties and interest, and I don't want anybody to have to pay penalties and interest.
Well, I mean, this time of year, I guess the shopping and the shoplifting and all of that is a factor.
It is, Ken. You know, it's going to be a very busy season. I do think that the economy, it may be slowing some, but I think it's still going to do overall be fairly well this holiday season. And so when you go shopping, I always say try to shop with a few people. Try to shop in day as opposed to night. Parking, if you have to shop at night, park in a well-lit area. And just to be mindful, when you're going from your car into the store, or when you're going from the store to your car, just look around your surroundings. If you see something that makes you nervous, you know, go ask somebody for some help. But I think if we do those kind of things, I think we can stay much safer, and your belongings will be safe as well.
You can't afford to be without your vehicle. Bobby and his team of professionals at A1 Quick Oil will get you back on the road fast and with the job done right. All technicians are 100% certified. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars, we fix them.